Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of The Dip. I am your host, TV Chips. That was weird. I don't know why I stopped. Haven't done like an update in a little bit of a bit. I haven't done an update in a while. Ugh. Today is going to be a struggle with the words, my friends. So strap in. It's 4 p.m. Good God almighty. So I haven't done an update in a while, and I haven't done a few things in a while. We'll get to that in a second. So I wanted to do just a quick kind of update recap. I am now at like 6, 9. I had like a 6-week checkup like a week ago. So I'm like 7 weeks with, if you carry the 4, I had surgery in January. So however long, it's been a weird, like the weeks and months haven't really synced because February is like a short month, throws everything off. But anyways, I had my surgery on January 20th. I think we're like 7 weeks. I don't know. I did advance to regular food. Yay. So I've only got like a couple more restrictions that need to be lifted, and then otherwise I'm free. I can eat just about whatever. So basically right now I can eat just about anything. I can't have hard vegetables still, hard raw vegetables. So no raw carrots, no raw broccoli, no raw cauliflower. That's like a year. That's gonna be a long time before I can have that. I also can't have most breads. I can have some like whole wheat things. Is it whole wheat or whole grain? Let me check my list. I can have whole wheat stuff and some whole grain stuff. I have this list, all right? So they gave me this list. This is my grocery shopping list. I don't have to buy all this stuff, but like it shows me, it breaks it down. Stuff that I can eat. I have another list that tells me some of the stuff I can eat and some of the stuff I can't eat. I should find that. But actually, since I'm off restrictions, I think this is pretty much, this is like my go-to. And then they gave me this thing for like snacks, like snack ideas. I'm having trouble getting food down still because of nausea. So, eating is still a struggle for me. I'm still eating too fast at times. I'm still, for some reason, eating a little bit too much at times. And so, shortly after I begin eating, there is movement and activity down there. The natives get restless. And so, eating with me is a fun adventure because it's like, bleh, bleh. And then there's always the threat. There's always the threat that, but I haven't had anything go in quite a while. So we're good. It's been a couple weeks since anything went. Although, honest to God, every day it feels like it. So yeah, still having issues with the nausea. I am so burnt out on shakes right now. It's not even funny. And I've got like 4 cases of Premier Protein chocolate shakes in the basement. I'll go back to them. I'll be fine. But right now, I can't do it. I should be eating, ideally, I should be eating 5 times a day. I am trying my best. During the week, it's a lot easier. There's more structure because of work. There's that structure. During the weekends, it's all hell breaks loose. It's like we're rolling at 4 o'clock. I slept in because I had a late night. I had a long day yesterday, and I didn't go to sleep until really late. So I woke up about like noonish, like 11:30, and then I like slept. Honestly, I just laid in bed for like an hour and a half, 2 hours. So I didn't really get started with my day till probably about 2. That was when I ate for the first time. Please don't tell my dietitian this. She will literally strangle me. So I didn't eat for the time being. I ate a bowl of cereal. I have this Special K cinnamon brown sugar puff protein thing, which is amazing. It's my favorite. I like it. I do like it. So I can eat that. It's a little bit bigger chunks. Doesn't go down that great, but it goes down okay. So I eat that instead of a lot of other things. It does have a little bit more protein, so that was approved. It's on the list. It is. It's on the list. It's right here. It says, in fact, high protein cereals, Special K high protein. Boom! Right there. Cereal. So been eating that a lot. I like that. But I had a bowl of that and that was about it. That's all I had. So far today. So getting food in is rough and tough. It's very difficult now also to get, a protein because I'm having trouble with the shakes. I'm not getting the right amount of protein in. I have started with protein bars. So those have been helpful. But I did get these, they're called New Way. They're these vial tube looking things. And they come in flavors and it's liquid protein. It's a 4-ounce drink. And it's 40 some grams of protein. So I have those. I haven't had to use them yet this week. So, hey, that's great. I did order a box of them. I've got like tropical or fruit punch, orange grape and blue raspberry flavor. Haven't tried them yet. Haven't needed to. Been getting the protein in. So that's good. It's a supplement. It's not a go-to. I'm not having them every day. Nor am I supposed to. Well, I can have a little bit of it every day, but I need to get at least 40 grams of protein in via food, and then I'm kind of able to get myself over the hump with the liquid protein. So that's where that stands. Good. Water's been okay. Some days are better than others. Water, I've found some delicate balances. I've found things that I can drink a lot easier. Water itself isn't great, but if I mix it with Crystal Light, it's good. And actually, if I mix it with half fruit punch Crystal Light and half pink lemonade Crystal Light, so good. So good. That's my favorite so far to drink. So I crushed that quite a bit this week. So I actually did good this week with both my water intake and my protein intake. So that's where that stands. As for everything else, the play I'm directing is coming along nicely. I think I've found a couple of extra actors, so I'm excited about that. I am working on a special project with some friends of mine, and we are very close to making an announcement on that. That will drop here on this channel before it goes anywhere else, so be excited for that. I have a wedding in May. I'm giving my friend Heather away, and I may have a date already. What? What? Maybe. We'll see. So that's exciting, right? That's exciting. Like a girl, has agreed to like go on a date with me to a wedding. So it's what a time to be alive. What a crazy, wacky world we live in. So anyways, I'm going grocery shopping today. My plan is I have turkey burgers, that I've been making myself, and just throwing them on the Foreman grill. So they're pretty small. They're about that big. They're only maybe about 4 or 5 ounces a piece. But I've been taking ground turkey, making those up, making burgers out of them, seasoning them a little bit. And then I just throw those on the Foreman grill. And I've got a quick meal. Those have been a really good meal for me. I'm going to get some more of those. I'm going to switch it up with some of the seasonings though. So I'm going to make some different seasonings with those. That's my plan. And then I also found this, Tyson frozen chicken. It's like chicken breast. It's like rotisserie or seasoned or whatever. Really good. It's actually really good by itself. But what I've been doing is I've been taking that every day for lunch. Like 3 or 4 little strips of that. Shredding it up a little bit with like a little bit of a sauce. So for this week, I tried on Monday, I had it with just Greek yogurt. Didn't look great, but it tasted really good. If you haven't already, if you're making like a tuna salad or a chicken salad, if you substitute Greek yogurt for mayo or Miracle Whip, you still get a really good amount of flavor, but you also get extra protein. So used on Monday, I did just Greek yogurt. On Tuesday, I used just mustard. I love mustard on chicken. On Wednesday, I did Greek yogurt and mustard. On Thursday, I did mustard and a loaf, like an olive oil based Miracle Whip. And then yesterday, on Friday, I did Greek yogurt and a tiny bit of barbecue sauce. So every day I had the same thing every day, but I mixed it up and had different sauces, so it didn't feel like I was eating the same thing every day. So that was good. Probably maybe get another, actually I don't know if I'll need another bag of that. I think I've got enough to get me through this next week, because one bag doesn't fill me up quite as much as it used to. So getting quite a bit out of that one bag, probably just get another one, just be safe. So I'm getting turkey burgers and I'm going to get those and everything like that. So we're good. But also I got to work on some snack things. I've tried, I found some little pieces of deli meat. I think it was like Oscar Mayer. They're little round, little itty bitty bites of deli slices. So I'm going to see if I can find those again. Those were pretty great. I'm going to get some deli turkey, some Sara Lee honey roasted turkey. Mmm, so good. I'm going to get some of that from the deli because that's the bomb. I'll also probably cut that up, maybe get some thick slices, cut that up, have those for some snacks. And then what else? I think that's it. I think those are going to be the big snacks for the week. I'll probably get some more beef jerky and some protein bars, and then that'll be it. But I also wanted to, this comes to the second part of the video. I haven't done like a tasting in a while. Obviously, I don't have the space to fit a bunch of stuff anymore. So I did have to cancel my Try Treats subscription because of that. I've been looking into my bariatric box. I might get that. I don't know if March's box is shipped already. I'm going to look into that today and see about maybe getting the My Bariatric box. I think that'd be kind of neat thing. But I have to find things that are pretty high in protein, some good quality snacks. So I went to the Whole Foods. You can't see it in the background. Maybe you can. But I went to the Whole Foods today. Okay. And I found a couple of things. I consulted my list and my snack list. And I found a couple of things that I can have for a snack. Now, obviously, with all snacks, you have to be very careful, and I need to go high protein. But you know, for you as a person regular too, maybe you want something high protein as well. Now, first things first, I found these. These are called Plentils. It's a chip. I like chips. Who doesn't like chips? So I found these. These are only 3 grams of protein per serving, so it's not high in protein at all. But it's not bad, 130 calories for a serving, and it's like 1 ounce per serving. So these aren't great, but they are free from wheat, dairy, peanuts, tree nuts, shellfish, fish, soy, egg, also made without casein, sesame, and sulfites. So these are like super allergy friendly. I picked these up mostly because so many people talk about allergy stuff nowadays. So these are like super allergy free, milk, gluten, soy, nut free, really cool, and non-GMO. I think a lot of people find that important. So I found these. Like I said, they're not super high in protein, but they do have a little bit of protein. They have more protein than most chips, so I'm going to try them. These are the garlic and parmesan flavor. So let's do this. That's what it looks like. It kind of looks like Munchos. Do you know Munchos? Those little chips? Munchos, that's kind of what it looks like. Oh! Oh, that's good. Mmm, yeah. Got the same texture as like a Muncho. That's really, really good. I only planned on eating one, but now I'm gonna have a second one. So these are okay. This is a decent snack compared to most things. There are healthier opportunities out there. Does that make sense? I don't know if that makes sense. There's healthier things out there to eat, obviously, but this is still really healthy. And they're very light. So I can imagine This bag, this big bag, has 4 servings in it. So about 31 chips. 31 chips in a serving. They're very, very light. Very, very light. Again, not getting a lot of protein, but you're getting a lot of calories. And in the ingredients, it's just lentil chips. It's got lentil flour, potato flour, salt, and turmeric. It looks like they're fried, maybe, or whatever. I don't know. They've got sunflower oil. I don't think these are fried. They might be. Yeah, I think these are fried. So there's sunflower oil. And then for the seasoning, they use maltodextrin, rice flour, onion powder, natural flavors, prehydrated parsley, garlic powder, yeast extract, spices, and lactic acid. And, these are good. These are really good. So, lentils, I found them at Whole Foods. I imagine you can too. So there we go. Lentils, good quality. Now something that is on my protein, high protein snack ideas is this product called Enlightened. These are roasted broad bean crisps. There's 100 calories per serving, 7 grams of protein. They're high in fiber. These are gluten-free as well. And it's, but these aren't necessarily peanut-free. They are made in a facility that processes peanuts and tree nuts. So, it is gluten-free though. And it is high in protein. So if you're looking for something high in protein for a snack, this might be something that you might want to check out. It also looks like they have sriracha, wasabi, ranch, cocoa dusted, mesquite, barbecue, and other delicious flavors. This Whole Foods only had sriracha and sea salt. Because I can't do spicy foods, I got the sea salt. So let's see what a roasted broad bean crisp tastes like. These look very weird. These are very weird looking. I don't know what that is. That is so weird. It's like cased in something. The ingredients for this, these are broad beans. Broad beans are fava beans. Dirty. Sunflower oil, rice flour, and sea salt. So there's not many ingredients in that. But can you see that? That looks really, really weird. It's not focusing on it. Let's see. It'll focus on that. I don't know. It's not focusing on it. There we go. That's what it looks like. Let's see what it tastes like. I don't hate this. I don't hate it. Not one bit. I don't really feel like I'm eating a bean. I mean, it's got a little bit of that grainy bean texture. It tastes like something. But I can't quite... Excuse me. I can't quite place what it tastes like. But it does have a little bit of a familiar flavor. So, 1 ounce of these has 7 grams of protein and 100 calories. This is a good snack. They're good. I do like these. I wish I could figure out what that flavor is. It's very familiar. It's not beany. It doesn't taste beany. But it's got a very familiar flavor. These are very, very good. So... yeah, this is a really good snack. I'm gonna take these to work with me because these will be a nice little afternoon snack for me, and it's on my list. High protein snack ideas, it's on the list. Those are waters, by the way, that they also drink. If I'm not getting enough protein via food, then there are water options. Those taste awful. I do not like them, so I have to get other things. But, so, here we go. So, Enlightened broad bean crisps. Highly recommend. These are very, very good. And again, you can get them at Whole Foods. There might be other places you can get them. This is the only place I saw that had them. Maybe you can order them online too. Looks like they also have ice cream. So that would be something to check out. Maybe I'll go back and see if they have the ice cream at some point. Because it looks like it also has 7 grams of protein in the ice cream. So, Enlightened broad beans, very good. And then these plentils, very good. So very, very good. I actually like these more than those, but I like them both quite a bit. So, there you go. I'll do this again, I think, because, you know, some people have talked to me in the past about doing, like, healthier options and stuff like that. And I have an allergy to almonds, so almonds are everything. So for me, it's a little bit difficult. But, you know, a lot of people really do care about finding stuff that's healthy and stuff that's also maybe a little bit allergen-free. So I'm going to do this again. I'm going to go back to Whole Foods soon, and I'm going to hit up the snack aisles and the chips aisles and maybe see if I can find some other things that are high in protein. So, if you want to try them out, I highly recommend them, both the Enlightened and these Plentils. They're very, very good. These are obviously better for you, but still, hey, there you go. So that's an update. Thank you for watching. My 1-year anniversary is coming up on Monday, so I'm going to do a special video on Monday. So if you're watching this, I'm going to open it up to any, if anybody has any questions they want me to answer or has anything they want me to talk about or whatever like that, I'm going to make a video on Monday for like a happy anniversary video, and I'm going to answer a bunch of questions. My friends over at Comic Trips just did that, and I thought it was kind of a cool idea. So my 1-year anniversary is coming up, so for my 1-year, I'm going to answer anybody has any questions, you can go ahead and ask the dip. All right, thanks everybody, I'll see you later, bye.